Good morning, everybody.
Good morning.
And welcome to this third Sunday after Easter. It actually looks a lot better than it did last Sunday. No blizzard out there today, albeit a few lazy snowflakes drifting down, but I think maybe we'll take that over a blizzard. So I'd like to welcome everybody here in the sanctuary this morning. It's great to see all of you here. And I would also like to welcome everybody who will be joining later on to watch this service online. I would like to say, peace be with you.
And also with you.
And let's greet everybody around us with the great big wave. Do we have celebrations this morning? A quiet Sunday for birthdays? Oh.
No, it's Gloria's birthday on Tuesday. They're having a little party for her. Oh,
okay. Well, I think maybe Joy is going to grab her mother Gloria in so we can wish her a happy birthday. Oh, she's almost in here. Gloria, we're wishing you happy birthday. Any other celebrations this morning? Well, maybe I can add one. I found myself walking on the Doghide trails, and of course it's spring and I was enjoying everything spring out there. And then I got to the duck pond and I was greeted by this chorus and I'm going, where are the geese? No geese to be found. They were frogs. I have never heard frogs sound quite like that in my life, but it was truly amazing. And if you want to hear what those frogs sounded like, you could go there and visit, or you could look at my Facebook page. So it's marvelous to see spring happening. Let's move on to some announcements then. And before I get too deep into the announcements that are printed, there are a couple here that I want to mention. The first one is that we need ushers for the month of May. And I would also like to say thank you for the support and patience that you've displayed with our use of technology. We appreciate your patience and your support, and we really need it. Hohen is a really good and patient teacher. We do lots of planning and practice, but unexpected things can happen. And I think those of you sitting here have noticed a few of those unexpected things happening. So anyhow, we really appreciate your support and your patience. And then moving on to announcements that are printed in the bulletin. Next Sunday, April 25th, is Camping Sunday. And Hohen will have a Sunday off that day, so the worship committee is going to be providing pulpit supply. And we just want to say that we'll be focusing mainly on Camp Tapawingo. And I wanted to let you know in advance that Camp Tapawingo is gratefully receiving donations. Even though this year they haven't been able to plan any camping for campers at all. So we are hoping that we can still gather some donations to send off to them. They do have a project that they're working on to build a bridge, and the project that they've got up on their on their website says that for $25 you can buy a board for the bridge. I'm pretty sure they'll take any amount of money we can send them. But you can donate online, or you can bring your donations here, and we will see that those donations get to Camp Tapawingo. Also, there are copies of various versions of the Lord's Prayer on the table by the office door, and you are welcome to use whichever version of the Lord's Prayer you are comfortable using. I'd also like to mention that Reverend Hohen will be in his office here at the church Thursday mornings from 9 a.m. till 12 noon. Let's keep in our prayers this week Georgie Taylor, Edith Dahl, Natalie Rowley, Lucille Hoffman's family, and all of those that are dealing with illness and those that have lost loved ones in the past months. And please just let me know if there is someone that you know of that we can verbally include in our prayers from the pulpit here. Does anybody else have announcements this morning? Okay. So then moving on to the lighting of the Christ candle, it is a responsive reading. The Easter promise is grounded in the resurrection of Jesus Christ from death to life. This is a grace that, through the Holy Spirit, empowers our community life to new and deeper experiences.
We light this Christ candle, naming that gracious gift and
promise. And the territorial acknowledgement. In the spirit of reconciliation, let us acknowledge our relationship with the Indigenous people of this land. We acknowledge that we are gathering for worship on the traditional lands of the First Nations and the homeland of the Métis. We are all treaty people, bound by the understandings made in the agreement known as Treaty 6. And as we prepare for worship this morning, let us listen to the sound of the bell.
Now let us join call to worship. Come this day with hope, because God loves you. Come this day with peace, because you are forgiven. Come this day with joy, for Jesus Christ is risen. Because you live, O Christ, we live abundantly.
Let today's worship testify to our hope, peace, joy, and love, because of all our great love, God.
Let us pray. Great Spirit, Holy Wisdom, in these days of early spring, we wait and watch as life blossoms and opens on vine and stem. In this strange season of pandemic, open us to loving God as we wait and watch for healing and understanding and a new world to arise. In Christ, you invite us to see with new eyes and fill with wider compassion. Meet us in the places where we are wounded. Meet us in the shadows of our souls where we have not yet mined the gold of your life in us. Awaken us to this day that you are co-creating with us in spirit and truth, and in life and love and joy. Amen. Our opening hymn is from Voices United 229, God of the Sparrow. Let us pray prayers of confession. Gracious God, we gather before you in this time of prayer. We confess that all too often we look up to heaven for glimpses of grace while not seeing your grace that is revealed all around us. Loving God, as we struggle with our brokenness, open our hearts to the presence of your grace in the people around us. As they reach out to us, let us reach out to them so together we may be healed. Let us listen to the words of assurance. Grace is a gift from God revealed in moments of our connection with one another. Grace is a gift from God revealed in Jesus. For this we give thanks and praise. Amen.
Sunday, it's Easter Day. Jesus came back from the Resurrection Sunday, it's Easter Day. Jesus came back from the grave, it's Easter Day. He has risen today, I'm so excited to find Easter egg. It's Easter Day, come, 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 let's celebrate together. It's Easter Day, come, 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 let's share the joy of Easter. It's Easter Day, come, 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 let's celebrate together. It's Easter Day, come, 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 let's share the joy of Easter. Let's share the joy of Easter.
Our first scripture this morning comes from Acts chapter 3, verses 12 to 19. When Peter saw it, he addressed the people. "You Israelites, why do you wonder at this? Or why do you stare at us, as though by our own power or piety we had made him walk? The God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob, the God of our ancestors, has glorified his servant Jesus, whom you handed over and rejected in the presence of Pilate, though he had decided to release him. But you rejected the holy and righteous one and asked to have a murderer given to you, and you killed the author of life, whom God raised from the dead. To this we are witnesses. And by faith in his name itself has made this man strong, whom you see and know. And the faith that is through Jesus has given him this perfect health in the presence of all of you. And now, friends, I know that you acted in ignorance, and did also, and as did also your rulers. In this way, God fulfilled what he had foretold through all the prophets, that his Messiah would suffer. Repent, therefore, and turn to God so that your sins may be wiped out." And our next reading comes from Psalm 4 in Voices United 727. Answer me when I call, O God, defender of my cause, for you set me free when I was in distress.
Be gracious to me now, and hear my prayer.
How long, you people, will you defame my honor? Know this, that God has chosen the faithful.
God hears me when I call.
Stand in awe and cease from sin.
Commune with your own heart upon your bed and be still.
Offer the sacrifices that are appointed.
And put your trust in God.
There are many who say,
"Oh, that we might see Christ, lift up the light of your face on us, Father."
But you have put gladness in my heart more than those whose grain and wine are plentiful.
Safe and sound, I lie down and sleep, for you alone, God, made me dwell in safety.
Our final reading comes from Luke chapter 24, verses 36 to 48. While they were talking about this, Jesus himself stood among them and said to them, "Peace be with you." They were startled and terrified and thought that they were seeing a ghost. He said to them, "Why are you frightened? And why do doubts arise in your hearts? Look at my hands and my feet. See that it is I myself. Touch me and see. For a ghost does not have flesh and bones as you see that I have." And when he had said this, he showed them his hands and his feet. While in their joy they were disbelieving and still wondering, he said to them, "Have you anything here to eat?" They gave him a piece of broiled fish, and he took it and ate it in their presence. Then he said to them, "These are my words that I spoke to you while I was still with you, that everything written about me in the law of Moses, the prophets, and the Psalms must be fulfilled." Then he opened their minds to understand the scriptures, and he said to them, "Thus it is written that the Messiah is to suffer and to rise from the dead on the third day, and that repentance and forgiveness of sins is to be proclaimed in his name to all nations, beginning from Jerusalem. You are witnesses of these things." Hear what the Spirit is saying to the church. Thanks be to God.
Let us pray. Come, Holy Ghost, our souls inspire, enlighten us with your celestial fire. For if you're with us, then nothing else matters. And if you're not with us, then nothing else matters. Be with us, we pray, in the name of your beloved. Amen. Last Sunday, we looked at Caravaggio's paintings, particularly through his masterpiece, The Incredulity of St. Thomas. We are able to reimagine the very moment where in the Gospel of John we are told that the risen Christ let Thomas touch his wounds. Jesus may have felt pain when the finger of Thomas was in his side, yet Jesus' attention is directed to Thomas. Thomas's face shows surprise as Jesus holds his hand and guides it into the wound. Following the lectionary reading, we are invited once again to reflect on another appearance of the risen Christ through the Gospel of Luke. Jesus once again encourages the disciples to look at his body and touch it. "Touch me and see, for a ghost does not have flesh and bones as you see that I have." Resurrection is a mystery. Believing in resurrection should mean believing in not only what had happened 2,000 years ago, but also what is happening to us today. To believe in the resurrection means to participate in the mystery of faith. Jesus says to the disciples, "Touch me and see." And how can we touch the body of Jesus Christ and see it? In this reflection, we are going to explore the meanings of the flesh and bone of the risen Christ and ours. Jesus had a body. Jesus was a body. The Word became flesh. We all have a body. We cannot live our lives without our body. We are our body. Now I'd like to invite you to see two short video clips regarding dance. Dance? All of a sudden, videos about dance. Because dance is very bodily expression. It may help us really see our body. So dance communicates through the body. So the first one is the final scene of the classic movie Zorba the Greek. Yeah, I believe that this is one of the most beautiful ending scene in cinematic history. And the other one is a music video of The Lord of the Dance by Sidney Carter.
Teach me to dance. Will you?
Dance? Did you say dance? Come on, my boy. Together. Let's go. Up. Again. Up. Down. Yasu Levendi. I have so much to tell you. I never loved a man more than you. Hup. Hey, boys, did you ever see a more splendiferous crash? Hey,
you laugh. You saw how they all ran.
Especially the monks.
The third time was the best. Nothing left.
Hey.
Follow me, so I danced with the fishermen James and John. They came with me, and the dance went on.
Dance then, wherever you may be. I am the Lord of the dance, and ye, and I'll lead you all wherever you may be. might be, and I'll lead you all in a dance," said he. I danced on the Sabbath and cured the lame. The holy people, they said it was a shame. They whipped and they stripped and then hung me high, left me there on a cross to die. Dance then, wherever you may be, I am the Lord of the dead," said he. "And I'll lead you on wherever you may be, and I'll lead you all in the dance," said he.
Dance on a Friday when the sky turned black. It's hard to dance with the devil on your back. They buried my body and they thought I'd gone, but I am the dance and I still go on.
Dance then, wherever you may be, I am the Lord of the dead, said he. And I'll lead you all wherever you may be, and I'll lead you all in the dance, said he.
They cut me down, but I leapt up high. I am the life that will never, never die. I live in you if you live in me. I am the Lord of the dance, said he.
Dance then, wherever you may be, I am the Lord of the dance, said he. And I'll lead you all wherever you may be, and I'll lead you all in the dance, said he. Dance then, wherever you may be, I am the Lord of the dance, said he. And I'll lead you all wherever you may be, and I'll lead you all in the dance, said he. I'll lead you all in the dance, said he. I'll lead you all in the dance, said he.
So the first video clip is from the Zorba the Greek. I just assume that you have seen this movie. No? Anthony Hopkins? When you date? Okay. Anyway, so whenever I saw this final ending, I always smile. It's so beautiful and joyful. Creation story affirms that our bodies are good. God looked at all of this creation and proclaimed that it was good, very good, in Genesis 1:31. Incarnation also proves that our bodies are good, and the Word became flesh and stayed for a little while among us. We saw the words of glory. Our bodies are often dismissed, ignored, disliked, and hidden. Our body images are affected by manipulated and idealized bodies in the media. Sometimes we may feel that our bodies are not good. We may feel that our sick and old bodies are not enough. When we look at our old bodies in the mirror, we may feel we are not enough. However, when we sing, "Yes, Jesus loves me," we need to remember that Jesus loves all of us, not only our soul, but also our body. We are called to respect and honor the bodies of our neighbors as we respect and honor our bodies. The physical is never separated from the spiritual. Our body is a temple of the Holy Spirit who is within you, according to 1 Corinthians chapter 6, verse 19. The birth of Jesus, the life of Jesus, the death of Jesus, and the resurrection of Jesus all happened through the body of Jesus. Whether we believe in the bodily resurrection or not, it is remarkable that one single consistent description of the body of the risen Christ in the four Gospels. The risen Christ had wounds. The body of the resurrected Jesus was awesome, like superheroes. According to the gospel, he could pass through doors and walls and change his appearance. He could even fly, which the ascension implies. Yet, he still had scars. The risen Christ would have had no wounds in his brand new body. Why were the wounds not removed from the body of the risen Christ? For us, the wounds may feel like a shortcoming. Yet, they were not a defect, but rather a glory of being fully human. The risen Christ was the wounded Christ. If we expect someone else with a sinless, perfect body, from our perspective, we cannot meet the risen one. As Jesus asked St. Thomas in the Gospel of John, here again in the Gospel of Luke, Jesus asked disciples, "Look at my hands and my feet. See that it is I myself. Touch me and see." Why does Jesus sermon us to touch his wounds and see them? Touching wounds or seeing wounds is uncomfortable, disturbing, and challenging. Touching the wounds of the body of Christ, connecting the pain of the world, and feeling the suffering of the least of this world, all are difficult and demanding. One of the members of the anti-racist study group told me that she is overwhelmed. The more she knows about racism, the more she sees it everywhere. She is sensitized to bias, prejudice, discrimination, systematic racism, and white supremacy. I am all part of this. Racism won't just go away, but I don't know where I should start. I am sure that she is touching Christ's wound instead of avoiding the pain. Awareness of the inerasable painful scars of the oppressed, the ignored, the dismissed, and the despised is never easy. Yet it is what Jesus asked us to do. Touch me and see. When we are touching the wounds of Christ, when we are open to see and touch one another's pain and difficulties and grief, we are becoming witnesses of these amazing things. We are being built into a dwelling place for God, where woundedness is welcome, understood, and healed. In the Lenten journey, a kind of earworm got stuck in my head. This cognitive itchiness was about I danced in the morning, especially the last verse of the lyrics. They cut me down and I leap up high. I am the life that will never, never die. I will live in you if you live in me. I am the Lord of dance, said he. This resonates with the words of Jesus. On that day, you will know that I am in my Abba, and you in me, and I in you. When we live in Christ, Christ lives in us. The risen Christ is calling us to touch the body of Christ and see it. The risen Christ is inviting us to dance in creation with God and be part of the new reality. Let us respond to this call with all our hearts, with all our souls, and all our might. I'd like to invite you to take a moment for meditation with Maurice's music. The next hymn is from Voices United 352, I Danced in the Morning.
Thank you.
As we ponder the gift of Jesus Christ, we are overwhelmed by God's love, which goes to the cross for us, endures the grave, and leads us to new life. Let us offer our gifts and our lives and respond to all that we have received from God. Offering hymn is from Voices United 541, Praise God from whom all blessings flow. Pray. Risen Christ, you startled us when you came into our world. You startled us when your love touched our hearts. You startled us with your kindness and open hearts. You startled us when you rose from the dead.
Receive these our gifts, we pray. Startle us again by your word, which is impossible. Then bring us to ourselves.
Amen. Amen. Please be seated. Let us continue to pray prayers of the people. God of our beginnings and endings, Alpha and Omega of the whole universe, we have come in awe to continue our celebration of Easter. You have spoken to us your word of peace. All-powerful God, you are present in the whole universe and the smallest of your creatures. You embrace with your tenderness all that exists. Pour out upon us the power of your love that we may protect life and beauty. Fill us with peace that we may live as brothers and sisters, harming no one. O God of the poor, help us to rescue the abandoned and forgotten of this earth, so precious in your eyes. Bring healing to our lives, that we may protect the world and not prey on it, that we may sow beauty, not pollution and destruction. Touch the hearts of those who look only for gain at the expense of the poor and the earth. Teach us to discover the worth of each thing, to be filled with awe and contemplation, to recognize that we are profoundly united with every creature as we journey towards your infinite light. We thank you for being with us each day. Encourage us, we pray, in our struggle for justice, love, and peace. We pray that the dying will be gently cared for and those who have lost ones will be assured of comfort. We pray for those we know who are sick and for members of this community of faith. Particularly, we pray for Edith, George, and Natalie. Following the prayer cycle of Living Skies Regional Council, we pray for Earth Sunday and Yellowgrass United Lutheran Partnership and Abbey Lancer Port Leave. With the Ecumenical Prayer Cycle, we pray for the churches and people of Belarus, Moldova, Russia, and Ukraine. We are thankful for the distinctive icons, art, literature and music that have come from this area, and for all those who help to alleviate the suffering of people due to the conflict in Ukraine, and who try to counteract and overcome divisions. We pray for those in Belarus and Ukraine who suffer from the continued effects of the Chernobyl nuclear disaster, and those who struggle for democracy and truthfulness in the media. And we gather all our prayers together into the prayer Jesus taught us, following our own preferred translation, saying, O Brother, Father, Mother of the cosmos, focus your light within us, make it useful. Create your reign of unity now. Through our fiery hearts and willing hands, help us love beyond our ideas and sprout acts of compassion for all creatures. Animate the earth within us. We then feel the wisdom underneath supporting all. Entangle the knots within, so that we can mend our heart's simple ties to each other. Don't let selfish things delude us, but free us from what holds us back from our true purpose. Out of you, the astonishing fire, returning light and sound to the cosmos. Amen. Our closing hymn is from Voices United 296. This is God's Wondrous World. Like the woman who ran to share the good news of the empty tomb.
Let us go forth with joy.
Like the travelers walking on the Emmaus road.
Let us go forth with open eyes.
Like the disciples receiving the Holy Spirit.
Let us go forth with peace.
Like Thomas filled with doubt.
Let us go forth with faith.
Like fishers pulling heavy nets.
Let us go forth with abundant life.
Amen.